Welcome to another video.
Today we're looking at the Sony TC-WE435 tape deck from 2000 and 2001. It's got a lot of features. It's got dubbing, it's got music surge, it's got pitch control. On paper, it's really good. This particular tape deck was given to your granddaddy or my dad by a coworker who was leaving the country about 2001. It was new in the box. He'd never used it, and he didn't want to take it out of the country. So it just sat there on a shelf for 18 years, and granddaddy got it out and tried to use it the other day, and it didn't work. Basically sat around. It's got a fader. It's got auto level control. It's got all sorts of cool features. What's that keychain about?
I'm Mr. Pooh.
Okay, let's not have that on there.
It's Godzilla. He's attacking.
Yeah. Godzilla would probably help this tape deck. So let's see what happens.
Press play. Where? Either one of those. Either direction.
Which one?
Didn't matter. It's going to fail. Try any of the buttons. Fast forward, rewind, anything. Oh, you get some clicking noises.
Nothing else.
Yep, doesn't work.
What happens? It just sort of clicks and clacks and makes a lot of noise and...
Clank, clank.
Yeah, and nothing ever happens. No movement from the tape mechanism whatsoever. So let's dig into this thing and see what's wrong.
Hey, Godzilla.
Godzilla has to get out of the way. So as you can see, the belts aren't turning. And I was able to get it turning by just kind of like manually kick-starting it and then putting it in pause mode quickly. So I put it in pause mode, let it run. I tried all the usual tricks with alcohol, tried putting a little sandpaper on there to give it a little thing, but the belt is just worn out, even though it's had no use. I guess it just sat there.
Nope. If I manually turn it back here. The belt just didn't have enough tension to move it.
After a while, it gives up and gives us an E, a flashing E for error.
Error, access denied.
This is the oldest, the newest tape deck we've probably ever shown on this channel. Let's look at some of the older tape decks. This Cassette, which we have featured in other videos, from 1970. We have another thing, the Ampex. They had their original belts, and they're still working. You know, and they were probably actually used. And those weren't flat belts, though. This one did have flat belts, the Technics M222. I was able to boil and sand those, and those came back just fine. But the Sony just pretty much sat there, and it was stored inside in a closet, and no use. And it the belts were just totally bad. So anyway, let's fix these belts. These belts on the left are kits that are they're square belts. They're easy to find on Amazon or eBay, and they're really cheap. These are flat belts, and they're hard to find. I haven't found a good source yet. If anybody knows of one, leave one in the comments. But
comment down below.
Because I had to actually order a specific belt for this tape deck, and they came in this little box. It was $10, including shipping, which is really high for just some little rubber belts. It's a double cassette deck, and so you get the flat belt and the other belt for each one. So anyway, let's repair this. The first deck, I actually went through the proper procedure and unhooked all the things. It was a pain to get to. You know, it actually took a while to unscrew all the stuff, separate this stuff. On the second deck, I cheated. Slightly bent the motor back, and much like sliding a piece of paper under a door, I was able to get the belt around there and got it all fixed.
Dad cheated in a game called Repair the Tape Deck.
Yeah. So the inside construction of this tape deck is just not that impressive. It's got one big board. Everything's mounted on the board, even the little connectors that hold the wires down. It's got these flywheels, which are mostly plastic. They have a, you know, disc on there that looks like it's just sort of stuck in the middle, but it's all plastic. They couldn't even use real wires. They use these ribbon cables. And all the switches on the front are just like button switches, whereas like if you think about one of the last tape deck we did a video on was a Marantz. It had a metal flywheel. It had real switches. It was a lot better constructed. You know, everything here is like these cheap, dinky little buttons. Why is this thing constructed so cheaply? Why such low quality?
I think I've heard this from a car commercial, but it says, cheap, seldom, fast.
Yeah, well, here's a website on the RIAA's data page that lets you kind of look at sales by year. In 1983, when CDs first registered, they were 0.1% versus tapes, 41.4% of pre-recorded music sales. And as we go through the years, you can see CD gradually starts to swallow everything up.
What's a mini blue area?
The orange is CD, the light blue is tape. So when this tape deck came out, CD was 91%. So
Look at all these CD players.
Yeah. So by 2001, for pre-recorded tapes, everybody was buying CD. People still had tapes at home. They made home recordings. City ad from 2001, they're selling CD burners and MP3 players. Very few tape decks in here. Also, since 1998, MP3, Napster, Winamp, that's all over the news.
And now today, guess what?
What?
We have iPhones and iTunes and AirPods.
So if you're kind of technically savvy and had a PC like me in 2001, I was probably burning stuff to CDRs. Sony only offered 4 tape decks, and this one was one of them, and they had that gold nice one, but... You know, there really wasn't a lot of incentive for Sony to put a lot of effort into these tape decks. You know, if you're buying it in 2001, it's pretty much a utilitarian effort and tape's on the way out. Feature-wise, it has everything you'd want. You know, dual tape decks, dubbing, all this cool stuff. You can make great sounding tapes off a CD, but it just is not that well constructed. But anyway, that's about it. You have anything else to say?
Please subscribe and hit the bell button and like the video. See you next time for another video. If we get 10 likes, we'll do a Sansui video.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.